Let's look at the overview of navigation equipments used in a ship. A ship uses various types of electronic equipments for navigation of the ship. The main purpose is to know the position, speed, heading, time required to arrive at the destination, communication and signaling, avoid collision and accident, distress management, etc. Here is an overview of the navigation equipment used in ship. First, look at the gyrocompass. A gyrocompass is a form of gyroscope used widely on ships employing an electrically powered, fast-spinning gyroscope wheel and frictionless forces, among other factors utilizing the basic physical laws, influence of gravity and earth rotation to find the true north. Guys, next one is magnetic compass. A magnetic compass works by detecting the earth's natural magnetic fields. This allows the needle to better react with the nearby magnetic fields. Since opposites attract, the southern pole of the needle is attracted to earth's natural magnetic pole, north pole. This is how navigators are able to discern north. Next one is radar or ARPA. A marine radar with automatic radar plotting aid or ARPA capability can create tracking using radar contacts. The system can calculate the tracked object course, speed and closest point of approach, thereby knowing if there is a danger of collision with other ship or landmass. There are two bands of radar used on board ship. The first one is X-band. It is widely used because of the ability to utilize small antennas and that can fit on most board and provide better target resolution. The frequency used is 9 GHz. The next one is S-band. It is used for specialized applications such as seeing through the heavy weather or precipitation and for long range bird detection. The frequency used is 3 GHz. Next equipment is autopilot. Autopilot is steering and heading control system. It works on PID, positional, integral and derivative control system. Autopilot operation is simple, but vessel on the desired heading, hold the course for a few seconds, then press auto and release the helm. The autopilot will log the course in the memory and will respond with helm corrections to keep your boat on this course. The next one is speed log. Speed log is an instrument used in ship to measure the ship relative speed with water in which it is traveling. The type of log widely used on board ship are Doppler log. It uses the principle of Doppler effect. A pair of beam, that is ultrasound waves, is transmitted in fore and aft direction at an angle of theta to the waterline. The frequency of the received signal is compared with the transmitted frequency to measure the Doppler shift to calculate the ship speed. The transducer used is SDME, speed and measuring equipment. The next one is electromagnetic log. It uses the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. An electromagnetic force is induced in a conductor whenever there is a relative motion between the conductor and magnetic field. There is a coil in the sensor at the top of the measuring rod and the coil is energized to establish a magnetic field around the sensor. As the ship moves, an EMF is induced, which is detected by a pair of electrodes at the tip of the sensor. Next equipment is echo sounder. Echo sounder consists of a transducer mount at the bottom of the ship hull and the main unit that displays information on the depth and formation on the seabed. This information is gained by the ultrasonic waves sent from the transducer that are then reflected off the sea bottom and picked up again by the transducer. Typically used 50 kHz to 200 kHz frequency. One is DGPS, that is a differential global position system. This is a system to improve the position fixing accuracy by receiving the correct data with the beacon receiver for a given GPS satellite, which is transmitted by a beacon station. The non-real-time position. One is Navtex. Navtex is known as a navigation text messenger used on board the vessel to provide a short-range maritime safety information in coastal water automatically. The broadcast station transmits navigational warnings, meteorological warnings, SAR, that is research and rescue information, and other data for shipping in this range. The service range is 200 to 400 nautical miles depending upon the terrain and transmitting power. The next one is anemometer and anemoscope. Anemometer used to measure the wind speed and direction. Anemoscope is used to show the direction of the wind. It is also known as vindicator. The next equipment is ECDIS, that is Electronic Chart Display and Information System. It is a geographic information system used for nautical navigation that complies with the International Maritime Organization, that is IMO, regulations as an alternative to paper nautical charts. It uses GPS to pinpoint the navigational points, enhancing reliability on the electronic charts. Also interspaced with other navigational equipments to get the data feed from gyro, radar and ARPA, GPS, echoes and sounder, speed log, AIS, etc. The next equipment is navigation lights. Navigation lights are used while navigating a vessel nearby coastal areas, in heavy shipping traffic areas, maneuvering at a harbor or simply sailing out of the sea. They help in indicating the ship's position, status, the direction of the course, etc. to the nearby vessel for avoiding the collision at the sea. Next equipment is ALDIS. The ALDIS, or All Day Light Signaling Lamp, consists of a lamp with a trigger-operated shutter that can be opened and closed. It is used for Morse code signaling, particularly between the ships at the sea. A halogen lamp is used, which is 12 volt or 24 volt or 60 watt. The next equipment is VHF. Marine VHF radio is a worldwide system of two-way radio transceivers on ship and watercraft used for bidirectional voice communication from ship to ship, ship to shore, and in certain circumstances ship to aircraft. It uses FM channels in very high frequency radio band in frequency range of 156 and 174 MHz. The next system is BNWAS. BNWAS, Bridge Navigation Watch Alarm System, periodically monitors its officers on the watch or properly in the bridge. When the system does not acknowledge the reset operated by one of the within a certain dormant period, it provides a visual indication first, and which the alarm timer is not reset within 15 seconds, it provides alarm 1, which is visible and audible alarm in the bridge. When over a 15 second passes, alarm to audible alarm. To transfer the chosen room, such as captain room, an officer who noticed it should go up to the bridge to deal with the situation appropriately so that he could prevent the accidents. The next one is a very famous one, GMDSS, the Global Maritime Distress and Safety System. It is internationally agreed upon the set of safety procedures, type of equipment and communication protocols used to increase safety and make it easier to rescue distressed ship or aircraft. It uses VHF, HF, MF and one of the in MARSAT depending upon the sea area like A1, A2, A3 and A4. Next one is EPIRB, the Emergency Position Indicating Radio Beacon. It allows a vessel to be located quickly and accurately in times of distress by the transmitting distress signals. EPIRB is a small portable battery operated radio transmitter that are both watertight and buoyant and transmitting a frequency of 406 MHz channel. EPIRB are carried aboard merchant ships, some private vessels, commercial and military aircraft. An EPIRB is designed to float in the water with the antenna pointing upright, and it is required to operate for a minimum of 48 hours continuously once activated. There are two types of EPIRBs are used in onboard, portable type and HRU, that is hydrostatic release type. First one is SAR. A search and rescue transponder is an electronic device that automatically reacts with the emission of the radar. This enhances the visibility of the radar screen. The SAR transponders are used to ease the search of a ship in the distress of a life craft. A SAR has a receiver that detects signals from X-band radars 9.2 GHz to 9.5 GHz. If the SAR detects a signal, immediately transmit 12 pulses on the same frequency. These signals are seen in the radar echoes. My dear friends, these are the navigation systems mostly used in the ship. Okay guys, see you.